The wind-excited tall buildings research project is a series of experiments I'm doing with Professor Kenny Kwok at the Institute of Infrastructure Engineering. He's a world expert in tall building sway, and buildings are getting taller all the time, taller and thinner, and they resonate. They resonate at low frequencies, particularly in the wind. Part of the work where we've conducted surveys that show that when the wind is particularly bad, people get nausea, they get tired, they get sleepy. We have shown these slow displacements of the body, even at levels that you can't feel, can cause changes in the body that lead to nausea. With global warming, the wind patterns are changing. More and more people are living in tall buildings and high density environments, and the winds are causing discomfort. Now, the building owners don't want to know about it. So we're trying to inform builders through this research that they need to take into account how much tolerance people have when the buildings sway. And as I said, they may not even perceive this sway, but the physiological changes in the body brought about by activation of the vestibular system will lead to changes in the sympathetic nervous system that are some of the markers of nausea. On this platform that you're seeing here, we do experiments where we record nerve activity, and they're exposed to these very low frequency movements. And in some people, it leads to nausea. We've already identified the critical levels of acceleration required to generate these physiological responses that lead to nausea. And they are at levels much lower than building manufacturers recognize. Ultimately, we hope we'll be able to generate new criteria for building construction that takes into account the fact that people can feel sick in these tall buildings.